This is a video response for King Heathen for his discussion concerning entropy and its explanation in terms of evolution. Don't get me wrong, King Heathen, for the most part I really like your videos. I'm a subscriber. I've even favorited a couple. But to be honest, your physics is a little bit shaky, and in this particular case, it's just plain wrong. I had hoped that I had given you sufficient information that you would research and find that out for yourself, and redo your video yourself so that you could present a video with an accurate argument. However, you haven't done that and have actually resisted the input that I'm giving you. So I'm just going to do a video response and correct your information for you. Dictionaries do not give good definitions for the jargon of technically specialized fields. Entropy is not a word that's very commonly used in day-to-day language, and as such, it's an even more technical area of the field of physics in which it's really used, and so the dictionaries tend not to get this one right. In university freshman level courses, entropy is usually introduced in terms of formula relating changes of entropy to changes in thermal states for the matter they're considering. And the students are merely told an assertion without any real explanation that entropy itself is a measure of the disorder or chaos of the system. It actually takes some understanding of quantum mechanics and some understanding of information theory, which the students do not have in their background at that level, in order for them to understand further explanation of what entropy itself really is. In fact, it is such a complicated subject, it's not something I can fully explain in a 10-minute video. But I will give a brief summary for what entropy itself really is and how that is indeed related to evolution. Entropy in itself is defined as a measure of the sum of microstates that a system occupies. When you have a system that you're considering, its microstates are not definite. They are indeterminate in accordance with quantum mechanics relations. In quantum mechanics, there are bits of information that don't even exist in a system so long as a observer or some interaction with some sort of matter is taking place in which the information is required to exist. Instead, you have a probability state. For example, a particle in transit, not interacting with matter, will not have a specific location state. It will enter a probability of location state until it interacts with matter or observers in such a way that the information regarding its position is required to exist, which collapses the wave function and actually causes the information to exist. This is in fact related to my proof that the Judeo-Christian concept of God, in which God is defined as something that is omniscient, cannot exist, because omniscience cannot exist when certain bits of the information of microscopic systems also do not exist, such as specific locations. But I digress. At any rate, when you're talking about entropy, you're talking about a sum of probabilistic microstates, the probabilities of each microstate, given by a sum over all of those possible microstates. If, for example, you have a box with a separation halfway between, and let's say you have two particles on one side and two particles on the other side, and we'll say, for example, they're bosons, so, and they're all indistinguishable, so the particles on the left side of the box could be in the exact same thermodynamic state, and the particles on the right side could be in the exact same thermodynamic state, then you could have the particles on the left having one temperature and the particles on the right having another temperature. And in fact, if they're in the exact same energy state, then it's dependent on the, and only one specific energy state, then it is actually dependent on the length of the container itself. But in any rate, you have two particles of one temperature on one side, two particles of one temperature on another side. There are your sum over these microstates is very small. You have basically one microstate possible on the left, one microstate possible on the right, small entropy. Now, let's say you remove the barrier and let those particles interact. Well, now, to oversimplify this, since you don't have a quantum mechanics background, let's say that there's some exchange of energy that takes place, and you could have the particles that were on the left could now be in the thermal state that they were in, and the particles that were on the right could now still be in the energy state that they were in. Or you could also have the particles all reaching various different temperatures whose average temperature works out to be equal to the initial average temperature, but they've exchanged some energy in this process. Now you have a greater number of microstates that they can occupy. In fact, the in a real calculation, which would involve quantum mechanics, the system would evolve over time, and the entropy would increase greatly. But in fact, it is a measure of the disorder or the number of possible microstates that has increased. So the entropy in itself, because the orderly state that it initially was in has gone to a more disorderly state in which there are more microstates in which the particles now occupy probabilistically, it's said to be an increase in disorder of the system or a measure of chaos. So entropy is merely told to the undergraduate, freshman, junior level students that it is a measure of chaos, but are not really given a full explanation at that point as to why that is. Hopefully now you have at least some superficial understanding of why that is. Now, you don't need a sun pumping energy into the Earth's system to explain evolution in thinking that it is a decrease of entropy, because evolution in itself is actually an example of an increase in entropy. So the sun argument is actually irrelevant.